Hello guys! Welcome to the 8th chapter of LinkedIn Marketing Hero, which is messaging your leads. In this lesson, we're going to talk about correctly reaching out to a contact through messages. LinkedIn messaging allows you to interact with any of your LinkedIn connections. You can send messages to anyone on LinkedIn only when they are on your first level connection, and LinkedIn members within the groups you are a member of as you engage with them. When you try browsing your first level connections network, which is your second level connection, you won't be able to send them a message unless you can successfully connect with them. When you are not connected to a LinkedIn member, you have the option to use InMail if your LinkedIn account is premium. To properly reach out to your contact through messages, follow these steps as your guide. Go to your LinkedIn profile, click the My Network menu, and click Connections. This will give you the list of your first level connections on LinkedIn. Beside their name, you can see the message button. Let's try to click one. You can use this message button to send them a personal message. Here's another way to do it. Click the name of the person that you want to contact. In their profile, you will be able to see the message button. As you click the button, you can compose your message, and when you're done, click send. But before you send a message, you must personalize every message depending on your leads. Leverage your mutual connection. If you want to connect with a LinkedIn member who is a direct first level connection of your first level connection, in short, that is your second level connection, you may ask them to introduce you to that person. Since your connection knows you, and as he introduces you to his connection that you want to connect with, there's a huge possibility of a successful connection. And you might be able to connect and message that LinkedIn member once you are connected. When you're already connected, you can message them in a way that you're introducing how you and your mutual connection know each other professionally. That way, you will catch your prospect's interest and attention. Whenever you have a successful connection with a LinkedIn member, send them a message where you thank them for accepting your connection. Use WIIFM. What's in it for me? The message has to be about your prospect. Your prospects do not care about how long you have been part of a company, your products or services, and how great your company is. They only care about what you can offer them. So don't make it about you and make it about them. Here's an example of a message talking all about you. So this is an example of what not to send. Now here's an example of a message talking about what you can offer to your prospect. Start with how you appreciate them accepting your connection. Then indicate a possible problem that your prospect might encounter and how you can help them. Craft your message by not being too pitchy like a salesman. People hate it when the reason why you approach them is to sell them something. This example is being too pitchy, instantly offering your services. By messaging this way, you won't get a response from your prospect. In this example, you're building rapport using the topics that you have learned from their profile and pointing out the benefit that they can get from working with you without the hassle of going through the long way of reaching that benefit. Give value to your leads. You can use their profile's headline and share a link to an article that could benefit your prospect. Indicate the reason why it is helpful to them so that it will spark more of their interest. When someone messages you, you can send them a reply via the messaging window on the lower right corner of your LinkedIn feed or profile. That is how you can easily reach out to any of your contacts on LinkedIn. Using the messaging feature of LinkedIn, you will be able to contact your network connections directly. Your goal is to make your prospect engage, so properly craft your message that you think will make them respond. Now that you have learned about correctly reaching out to a contact through messages, it's time to proceed to the next topic, which is how to schedule appointments through LinkedIn. See you there! Hello guys! In this lesson, we're going to talk about how to schedule appointments through LinkedIn. After you have created a successful connection with your potential leads, the first thing you would do is message them. You would build rapport with your leads and thank them for accepting the connection. Once you have shared value to your leads, like sending them a link to an article that could help them in their profession, you will make your leads feel that you are one of their valuable connections where they can build a professional relationship with. You have got their attention, interest with what you can offer, and gain their trust. Your number one goal is to make your prospects want to ask more about what you said, making them curious of how your service can help them. Proceed to the next step once you believe your prospect is hooked to your message and wants to know more. The next step is to schedule an appointment. Your goal is to make your prospect say yes. So don't ask this question directly. Would you like to set up a meeting? You will probably get a no from asking that, unless you have built a really good relationship with that prospect and he is interested to know more about what you can offer them. If you're just starting to build your relationship with your prospect, give them options that lead to where you want them to choose from. Here's an example. Give choices from Mondays to Fridays. You may ask, which do you prefer, Monday or Wednesday? Mondays could be busy for some people because it's the start of their week and they need to deal with work-related stuff, so give your prospect a second option as your ideal day to meet up with them. They probably won't choose Monday and go for your second option instead. Give time options. Give an earlier time and a few hours later than your first time option. You may ask, do you prefer 10 a.m. or 3 p.m.? Your prospect could be busy in the morning, so set your second time, which you think he could free his time as he could have lesser workloads at that time. Give place options. Offer to meet up in a place near his area or office, then offer an option that is near your area or office, so that when the prospect has a very busy schedule and has to go back to work right away, he can choose the option near his office. Determine how long the appointment meeting will last. If it will be a short meeting, you can always give the option of having something to drink, like tea or coffee. The ambience is relaxing and will add to your prospect's comfort with you. If you will be having a longer meeting, you can give an option where you can have a peaceful meal. That way, you can have a longer time to discuss with a prospect as you have a meal with them. By offering options to let your prospect choose, you are making him feel that he is the one making decisions for this meeting. Now that you have learned about how to schedule appointments through LinkedIn, it's time to proceed to the next topic, which is following up correctly. See you there! Hello guys! In this lesson, we're going to talk about following up your leads correctly. There are times when marketers who have successfully made a connection with their LinkedIn prospects are too aggressive to make a sale. They would give the facts of the product and how it benefits the prospect, but the problem is, the prospect doesn't know you and you haven't gained their trust yet. How would they purchase something from someone they don't know? They probably are interested with your product, but the timing is not right. They might not be looking for a demo or buying today, but soon they will. You just have to approach them the right way at the right time. People are likely to buy a product or avail your services when they keep on receiving facts about it for several times. They might still be researching about you, your products, searching for reviews and how it can really help them. So give them time. You have to follow up your prospects correctly to make them say yes. There are different types of prospects depending on how they respond to you. Let's look at each of them and how you can deal with each type. Prospect number one. These prospects will not waste time and would inform you to send more details or set up a meeting, and they usually are buyers up front. You won't have a problem following up with them. You're all set and just made your successful sale. You can follow up with them asking on their reviews about the product. Ask their feedback regarding how it benefits them. They'll be happy to inform you about it if they really like it. You're not stopping at that one successful sale with that client. You must keep on nurturing that client as he might know people who would love your product and recommend it to them. Prospect number two. Prospects who are busy to respond. These prospects might be aware of your product and the solution it can offer them, but they are too busy with their lives to reply to your message. They might have seen your message, but at that moment, they could be doing work-related stuff or at home taking care of their children. So do some research about your prospect. Check their website and other social media accounts. Look for common ground that you can mention in your follow-up message. Here's an example. Hi prospect, I looked at your website's products. What if I tell you that you can still increase your sale by 10% more by using our then mention the benefits of your service? I believe we can help you achieve those numbers and mention how we can help them. Prospect number 3. These prospects have responded to your message, but you haven't heard from them since. They probably are interested, but something came up and their priority has changed. They're still interested, but they need to focus on other stuff rather than what you can offer them. So here's what you can do. Send this message, for example, "Hi prospect, I know that we had a point in the schedule last week, but something came up that our meeting was cancelled. I do have available time this week. Are you free on Monday or Wednesday around 10 a.m. or 3 p.m.? If you prefer near your office, it will be okay." If they respond to make the meeting possible, that's good. But if they had reasons to postpone the meeting, respect their decision. What you can do is keep on following them up timely. You might be surprised that after a long wait, they would set a schedule to meet up with you, so be patient. Following up your potential clients demands your time, effort, patience, and persistence. Remember to follow up with the intent to give value to your prospects every time you send them a follow-up. Always find good, interesting topics that they could get value from. That way, they will not get annoyed upon seeing your name pop up as you message them and asking them when they would want to meet up to know more about what you can offer. When they know that they can learn something from you, they will always be eager to read your messages. Later, they will be the one to decide to set a meeting with you. Not all prospects have the free time to squeeze you in their schedule, so there are times that your appointments will be rescheduled or delayed. Don't take it personally. Now that you have learned these tips about following up correctly, it's time to proceed to the next chapter, which is LinkedIn advertising. See you there!
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and go to technicforce.com for more tools and training.